for you. And man, God just did an amazing thing, and we are so thankful for everything that he's been doing. But can I ask you guys, just for a moment, to be able to pull out your phones, send a text to a friend, a family member, whoever it is, whether they're in middle school, all the way up to high school, 12th grade, and invite them to service. Man, we're doing something.
Guys, I just want to challenge you right now that whatever you are.
That's exactly right. We're trying to enter
into. All right. Let's take a moment before we sing any more songs.
Well, there you have it, student ministry, night of worship. We hope you had.
Been reading books of old, the legends and the myths, Achilles and his gold, Achilles and his gifts, and Spider-Man's control, and Batman with his fist. And clearly I don't see myself upon that list, but she said, where'd you wanna go? How much you wanna risk? I'm not looking for somebody with some superhuman gifts, some superhero, some fairy tale bliss, just something I can turn to, somebody I can kiss. I want something just like this. Testaments they told, the moon and its eclipse, and Superman unrolls a suit before he lived. But I'm not the kind of person that it fits. She said, where'd you wanna go? How much you wanna risk? I'm not looking for somebody with some superhuman gifts, some superhero, some fairy tale bliss, just something I can turn to, somebody I can miss. I want something just like.
Somebody, 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 somebody.
Student Ministry, welcome. We are so glad that you are joining us this Wednesday. Man, I'm so excited that each and every single one of you guys are here. We are on week two of King of the Beach Week. You can see the shirt. I'm repping it. We are so excited. God has been doing an amazing work in our middle schoolers' life. If you were able to make it to camp this last week, can you put in the chat that you made it? Was it fun? What was your favorite part? I know my favorite part, slip and slide kickball. But no, I'm serious, man. God did so many amazing things. We had 44 people baptized, take their public profession of faith and say, man, Jesus, I'm going to live my life for you. And man, God just did an amazing thing. And we are so thankful for everything that he's been doing. But can I ask you guys just for a moment to be able to pull out your phones, send a text to a friend, a family member, whoever it is, whether they're in middle school, all the way up to high school, 12th grade, and invite them to service. Man, we're doing something a little bit different tonight, and I'm extremely excited about it. It's not going to be the normal message, not the normal Wednesday, but we're doing a night of worship. And I'm extremely excited about this because we need to continue to remind ourselves that worship, you don't have to be in these seats. That worship might not just be at the church or in an auditorium or doing a Bible study with your friends, but worship is a mindset. Worship is an attitude. And we're going to take a moment to be able to sing some songs tonight. And I want to challenge you to be able to, wherever you're at, whether it's in your room, your living room, to be able to pause, reflect, meet with the Lord, and worship him because he is worthy of our praise. And that's what we are going to do tonight. I'm so excited. I'm so excited that you guys have decided to join us. But hey, before we jump into it, let us pray. God, we love you. We are so thankful for everything that you have just continued to do in our life. God, when we're talking about worship, an object of our worship, God, there is no other thing that is worthy of our worship other than you. God, we love you. We are so thankful for a moment to be able to pause, spend a moment with you, and to be able to declare our praise because you are good. We love you, God. We give you this time. We give you our worship. We give you our praise. In Jesus' name, amen. Come on, so excited you're here. Let's worship, guys. Come on.
Guys, I just want to challenge you right now that whatever you are, that you just pause and you reflect and you don't allow any distractions to distract you from this moment, because it is so crucial. It may be your phone, it may be your dog. I don't know what it is, but I just challenge you to stay in this moment. It is so important. I know we're not at a church. I know we're not at a physical place, but it doesn't matter if we're at church, it doesn't matter if we're in a car, and it doesn't matter if we're on our laptop. The same God that gets you excited and pumped is the God that is with you right now. A verse that's been with me on my heart right now is Psalms 63:3, and it says, "Your unfailing love is better than life itself. How I praise you." This next upcoming song is Another in the Fire. It gets me pumped. It lets me know that no matter what struggle I'm going through, no matter the circumstance or the problem, that God is right there with me. And I hope that we could just take a moment, we can reflect, and we could just praise God for how great he is. So come on, let's worship and let's sing the song.
So come with me.
Cause I know that's where you'll be. I count the joy come every bad. Cause I know. I count the joy come every bad. I know that's where. I count the joy come every bad. Cause I know that's where you'll be. Even if he does, I'll praise him. Even if he does, I'll stand tall. Even if he does, I'll praise him. Even if he does, I'll stand tall. Even if he does, I'll praise him. Even if he does, I'll stand tall. Even if he does, I will praise him. Even if, come on, we stand tall. Stand tall. Would you keep singing that? Come on, keep on singing that out. Even if he doesn't come through in the way that I think that he will, I will praise him. Even if I stay in the fire and I feel like I'm alone for a little while, I'm gonna stand tall still. I'm going to praise despite the fire, despite whatever is coming at me from this world. Man, even when I don't feel like it, God, even when I don't feel like loving you, I'm gonna show you that I love you, because that's what mature individual can do, God. And I believe that you have the power to save me. If he does it, I'll praise him. Even if, see, the thing is, he's going to come through, but sometimes we have to wait. But we have to say that even if I'm waiting right now, I'm holding out, because I know that you are still there, God. And so I will stand tall. I will still praise you, God. I'll still lift your name up.
Thank you. your son for redemption, the price of my heart. And I don't have a conscience for that kind of love. I don't understand, can't comprehend. All I know is I need you. I run to the Father, I fall into grace. Done with the hiding, reason to wait. My heart needs a surgeon, my soul needs a friend. So I run to the Father again and again and again and again. Oh, 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 again and again. Oh,
that we get to run to the Father again and again and again. We don't have to be ashamed. Let's just sing that one more time.
Run to the Father, I fall into grace. I'm done with the hide, no reason to wait. My heart found a surgeon, my soul found a friend. So I run to Father again and again. I've run to the Father, I fall into grace. I'm done with the hiding, no reason to wait. My heart found a surgeon, my soul found a friend. So I run to the Father again and again and again.
That's exactly right. We're trying to enter into a time of worship. What does it mean to worship? I know that it can be difficult, like Tanner said, to be worshiping on your phone or on your computer in your living room or wherever you may be. If you're not in the sanctuary, if you're not here at church, I understand it can be difficult. But it doesn't mean that, just like that song said, we can't run to the Father and go where He's at. You know, I think in our lives, we're so quick to just invite God into our tiny little world, invite God into our tiny little problems, when in reality, God has made it accessible to us to leave that tiny little reality and go to where he is at, to bring those problems that we have here and bring him to a God that is so much bigger than our problems, so much bigger than our worries, and he gladly wants them. He wants to receive those, and he wants to meet us exactly where we are, but we have to be willing to run to the Father with all of these things. I was reading in Acts 16. It's pretty crazy. It talks about the Apostle Paul and a part in his ministry where he's actually arrested and imprisoned. And it's crazy. And he's there with his guy Silas. And through a whole mess of circumstances that was super unfortunate and super frustrated, they're actually put in prison. And what's so wild is that while they are there, locked up, their legs are shackled, their arms are bound, and yet they begin to worship the Lord. They're crying out, they're screaming to the Lord. How is it that these guys who are in this crazy place can just be in awe of who God is, can just lose themselves in whatever moment and whatever circumstances, whatever mess they've got themselves caught up in, and go and run to the Father? And we see through miracles that God comes through for them. And I'm telling you, no matter where you're at, no matter what you're going through, first off, I want you to know that you are so loved. I want you to know that there's a God who loves you so, so much. But he doesn't want to keep you there. He wants to push you forward in that love. Whatever chains are binding you, whatever shackles are weighing you down, he is asking you, he is begging with you to release those, to give them to him, to offer those to him, and let him take you so much further than you'd ever wonder, you would ever dream. He wants to go there with you. And that's what worship is all about. It is a time to connect. You can worship doing anything. Worship doesn't mean praise and music or praise and worship music. Worship is putting God before everything else. Heck, when I'm eating chips and queso, you better believe I'm in a place of worship, right? It is, this is so good, God, hallelujah, I love you. But when the music comes on, when we do create this incredible atmosphere, you do need to understand that it is a beautiful sound to the Lord. That when we can humble ourselves and understand that God wants to hear you. He loves it when we're together worshiping. You better believe last week at King of the Beach Week for our high schoolers, he loves it when we worship together, when we scream out, when we shout to the Lord, he loves it. Junior high students, this week it has been so incredible to see you lead out in that worship and scream out and cry out and praise the Lord. But just like Paul and Silas, they're in a prison cell by themselves. There's some guards there. Maybe there's some other inmates there. They don't care where they're at. They don't care how they got there. They care about who God is, and they worship the Lord. That is what I am challenging you to do. Get to this place, to this heart of worship, where we can stop worrying about all of these little things that want to take us away, and we can start thinking about who God is, about what he has in store for us, about what he wants for us. Just take time and be with him, and you are entering into a heart of worship. So we're gonna sing our next song, and I encourage you, please, 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 find that heart of worship. I'm gonna pray, and then we're gonna get into it. Heavenly Father, God, we love you. God, we thank you for who you are. God, we give this worship to you. We love you, God. We thank you. We pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
your time. You hear that voice? What are you gonna listen to? You gotta have lots of things. You got lots of insecurities telling you this is not your place. My voice might crack. I'm too tired. This is what's going on. You gotta decide, are you gonna be a fighter? Are you in the game? Are you gonna join me on this path that we call life into eternal life? Are you gonna get connected with the Savior of the universe that lives in you? You have to choose. What kind of man are you gonna be? What kind of woman are you gonna be? What are you gonna fight for? What is your life being worth living, given away for? This is your time. You gotta make your choice, but make it right here, right now. The gauntlet has been laid. This is your time to make a choice because this is your time. Let yourself find the peace that only comes from God. Because when you do, the promises are that when you put your trust in God, that He will be so excited to receive that connection with you, that that blessing will not only hit you in this room right now, but will go to your kids and your kids' kids and their kids to 1,000 generations. God will be so pleased to have you honoring Him with your voice, with your life, with your body, that He will not only bless you, but He will bless 1,000 generations behind you. That's how much He loves you. That's how much He wants you to overcome your body and do what God says He knows you can do. This is your song. Let's sing it together. Come on. Let's let His praise and let's let His blessings hit our lives and our families for 1,000 generations. Come on, here we go.
Children and their children, may His favor be upon you in 1,000 generations, and your children, and their children, and their children, may His favor.
All right, let's take a moment before we sing any more songs, before we go any farther, to be able to take a moment and reflect on what God has continued to do in our lives during this time of worship, whether it was before this, whether you came to camp this last week and God did something really awesome in your life, or even just being able to reflect, God, I've seen you move mountains in my life. I've been reading something in the Old Testament. I usually stay in the New Testament, but I've been really challenged by what I've been reading, and I've been reading about the Israelites. And specifically, a little bit about the Israelites, if you don't know, they are God's chosen people. They were held captive in Egypt. God set them free. The Israelites ended up going, God parted the Red Sea for them. They were walking around the desert. God ended up providing them food when there was no food, water through a rock. Man, God was continuing to do all these different miracles. And I was just like, man, this is so cool. And it made me be able to pause and say, God, what have you been doing in my life? And I've just been really challenged by this, but not that specifically. But there's a story after Moses ended up being gone, Joshua ended up stepping into leadership because that's who God appointed to be over the Israelites, to be able to lead them into the promised land where God desired and longed for the Israelites to be able to be. And there was just this really interesting story. And it's interesting because it's not that God parted the Red Sea for them again. But what's so cool is he stopped the water from flowing in the Jordan River during flood season. And this river, I don't know if you guys have ever went and floated a river before, but when it's flood season, it's just like, man, you can't, like in Arkansas during flood season, it's like, you can't tube, you can't go across it. It's like, well, we're just gonna have to wait to get to the other side. But what's so cool is he challenged the Israelites to be able to say, hey, the promised land's this way and we're going and we're not stopping. So as Joshua took his step of faith and said, okay, this is what we're gonna do, as he took the Ark of the Covenant across the river, the water just stopped. And I was like, man, this is such a cool miracle. And again, it's no different than in a sense, God parting the Red Sea or feeding the Israelites where literally raining food from heaven or countless other miracles. But I think what was so interesting was the Israelites' response in this, because a lot of times, I think what's so crazy about the Israelites is they saw God move in so many different ways. And you're like, okay, relatable. God's moved in so many ways in my life, right? Amen. But what's so interesting about the Israelites is they forgot time after time after time as they just continued to keep on going. They're just like, they just like forgot that God continued and did all these different things. And they're just like, well, I don't know where God is now. Like God just parted the Red Sea. And they're just like, well, I guess we're just going back to slavery because that's just the best thing for us. And it's just like, what? What do you mean? But what was so cool about this time after crossing the Jordan is Joshua told them, he said, hey, go grab 12 stones out of the water, smooth stones. And we are gonna build an altar to the Lord. And I think what was so cool about this is he challenged them and he said, okay, the reason we're doing this is for all of your ancestors, for the people that are coming after you, to be able to remember that God has continued to do amazing things. Because I mean, we have stories. We all have stories of God doing amazing things in our lives. Literally slaying giants. God has called you to do this specific thing and you're like, I'm terrified, but you did it. And you stepped out in obedience and God showed up in a powerful way. But have you forgot? Have you forgot? Have you looked on after clearing this mountain that God has gotten you through? Have you moved on to the next one and you're looking at it and you're just like, well, I'm going back to slavery. Or like, oh, I guess God's not gonna show up now. Well, I think what was so cool is after they ended up going from there, going into the promised land, they faced a lot of challenges. But what's such an awesome encouragement is when they felt fear and wanted to turn around, they turned around to 12 stones made in an altar. And remembrance. And we need to remember today, not to live off of that, but to be reminded to say, I'm gonna keep on going. Whatever is in front of you today, I don't know what that is. I know we're still not meeting together in person right now. I don't know if that's your struggling point, but can I remind you that God is gonna make a way in your life? God will never fail you. He has never failed us yet. He is worthy of our praise. We have seen victory after victory. So church, when we go into this next song, can we declare with our hearts, can we make altars of what God did at King of the Beach Week for you guys? Can we make altars for the last thing that the Lord did in your life, the last time he showed up? Because we need that reminder today. God is still gonna make a way regardless of where we're at. Come on guys, he is worthy of our praise. Let's sing this song, let's declare it, and let's live it out. Come on guys, let's sing, come on.
something powerful that happens when we declare God's blessing in our lives. And there's also something that's powerful that happens when we declare who He is. And that's what this song is about, declaring who He is.
Maker of heaven, maker of earth.
Come on, He's the maker.
The galaxy architect gave me my word. Could I predict it, this story you'd write? No. You stretched out the heavens. Sin and love collide. I stand in awe, arms open wide. The God who joined the hemispheres, join my fight. Here with sin and blood collide. My chains fall off, my fears subside. The God who made the universe. Thank you.
We can give God glory. We can give Him praise. That's what we're here for. But right now, especially, let's just tune our hearts to Him. There's no one else here. And not only bless Him with our praises, but let Him speak to you. Right? So stay in this moment right now as we continue to sing.
you, I lift your hands to the heavens. Lift your voice to the sky. Praise the Lord of all creation. Let his name be lifted high. Come on. Lift his name.
Well, there you have it, Student Ministry, Night of Worship. We hope you had as much fun as we did. We're going to continue on with King of the Beach Week for our amazing middle schoolers and junior high students. Please be praying for us. We are doing everything we can to stay safe and secure. We hope you have an incredible night. Do not forget about 9 at 9 on Instagram from Woodlands, from North Point, from Atascocita, Woodlands Church. We love you. Have an incredible night. To God be the glory. Amen.